Alright, good morning. It is the first day of school. Well, technically the first day of school was yesterday, but I don't have classes until today because I didn't figure out my schedule till yesterday. It's only like 11 right now. I don't have class till 3, but I'm gonna get all ready for class. If you can't hear, we're gonna focus. There we go. If you can't hear, it is again bucketing today. So the outfit I was planning on wearing just, you know, isn't gonna work. I also have a 20-minute walk to class in the rain. That's gonna be really fun. And yeah, that's about it, I think. So yeah, I'll go get ready for the day and we'll do a little chit chat while I do my makeup.
We are back. I have made my bed, I'm fucking dressed, did skincare, brushed my teeth, don't want to do yoga. So now I'm gonna do my makeup and then we'll have breakfast. So I'll give you a little recap of the past few days. Basically, because I'm exchange student, they usually want me to take second or first year courses. And I was like, no, screw that. Like, I want to take third year courses and I'm just going to put back this up. There we go. I want to take. Oh, God, I set up. No, so I want that to go. There we go. I want to take third year courses. I'm qualified enough to take them. I excel in my courses in Canada. And this university ranks a lot higher in the world than my university of Calgary for anthropology. So it's like, if I'm going to a university that's world class, my program, I want to be taking world class courses, or they call them modules here. And so I was corresponding with my advisor in my department, and he was like, yeah, it should be no problem, just wait till you get here, we'll figure it out. So then I get here, he basically tells me to just start emailing my profs and just like look at the courses I want to take, look at who's teaching them, email them, and all of them were like, yeah, you're fine, like, why are you, like, one of them was like, why wouldn't you be allowed to take this course? And I was like, oh, it's just because I'm an exchange student. He was like, no, you're fine. So then I was like, hey, I have to go ahead. I had to change up a few other courses because I had to enroll in some, but I wasn't really interested in taking them. I wasn't actually interested in taking them. I just had to enroll in courses. And so I had to drop those. And by the time I got around to like actually be approved to do my higher level courses, the little app we use, it's called Banner. The Banner is the reason I applied at least 3 times this week. Closed up on me and it wouldn't let me register on anything, so we've been trying to figure out for like 3 days who need to register in courses. And then I realized for me to be an exchange, I have to take 120 UK credits, which equals anywhere between 6 to 12 courses basically. Modules are 20 credits or 10 credits. They're 20 credits, they run the full year. They're 10 credits, they run half the year, or term, because there's. See, at home, this is another thing that kind of messed with me when I got here. At home, it is fall term, it is winter term. It is easy. Like, in the fall, is it winter, there's your term, and then there's spring and summer too. Here, the first year was called Michaelmas. I don't get Michaelmas. Sounds like not about Christmas. And then the second one's called Epiphany. And I've been so screwed over, like, which one's which? People are talking to me, and I'm like, I don't know, like, what's going on. So yeah, that's another thing. The term names are interesting, to say the least here. And so I've been going like back and forth, saying email to my poor advisor. He didn't know what was going on. I didn't know what was going on. It was just a bad time all around. Just trying to figure out how I can enroll these modules. And then I ended up having to take more because I did not know about this whole 120 credit rule thing. So now I'm enrolled in 6 courses a term, which is a little nerve-wracking because back home I usually take
4 and then do a spring course. I have not taken like 6 courses since like high school. I think even high school, I think I did 4 a term. I've never taken 6 courses before. So that's very exciting. I'm excited to start school. It was kind of sad yesterday because I didn't know what time classes were. I didn't know where they were happening, so I just kind of, I got my school supplies and stayed in my apartment, and that was basically it all day. It was a little bit sad to see everyone go about and have their kind of first day of school, and I was just hanging behind, sad. But I have one course today. It's like a 20-minute walk from my apartment, so not excited about that. And then I have to go get groceries for like the 3 millionth time today because I've been eating literally like ham sandwiches for every meal, and I am tired of eating ham sandwiches. Ham and cheese sandwiches, toast. I got sausage rolls the other day, and they were actually pretty good. They were really filling. What else have I eaten? Little tiny personal pizzas. They're actually good for children. I didn't know that until I the one was looking at the packaging and I was like, this is meant to be a child's snack. But you know what? No judgment. They were good. I'm looking to get more food. I talked about this with one of my flatmates the other night. I just can't be bothered to spend a lot of time cooking. I would rather be in my room watching something on Netflix or, I just can't be bothered to spend 30 to 45 minutes cooking something. I'd rather 5 to 10 minutes and 10 minutes max. And even I was impatient the other night waiting for my sausage rolls because they took 20 minutes to cook. And I was snacking a ton, and then I got to my sausage rolls and I just was not hungry anymore. So I just can't be bothered to cook a lot of the time. I'm also not a very good cook. So I think that has something to do with it because I'm just it's so unknown to me that it's not happen. I don't know, I can't vocalize this, but yeah, just cooking is so unknown to me. I'm not a good cook to begin with. If it can't be made in a microwave in 5 minutes, I can't make it. So I think I need to actually force myself to start cooking, or at least trying to cook. I think that will help a lot because I am getting tired of making the same 3 meals over and over again. I'm trying to save money by not ordering stuff like Uber Eats and it's called Skip the Dishes at Home. I think it's called Just Eat Here. Spending money on that and delivery. I'm trying to takeaway and restaurant meals to once a week, which I've been keeping to so far. My flat split. What did we split? We split pizza the other night, and that was really good. And then one of my flatmates is making dinner for us on Saturday, which I feel bad because I think that's 2 flatmates. Yeah, that's the second flatmate that's made dinner for us to all share, or something to that effect of either made too much or actually made for us to share. And I cannot cook, so maybe bake for them is what I'm thinking. I tried to bake the other day, and it just did not go well. And I think it's just because the stove is also very different from the one I have at home, where it's a little bit daunting. So I don't know what this button does. This button's either gonna cook my food or it's gonna make the stove self-destruct in 5 seconds, and I don't know which that is. So yeah, it's just a lot of unknowns. We've been chilling, excited for class to start. I think that's it. I finally went up clubbing the other night. That was interesting. But it was a lot of fun. Even in Canada, I haven't gone out clubbing or partying or anything like that. So that was kind of fun to do for sure. And that's it. So I'm just gonna finish up my makeup. I think all of my vlogging for the day, I don't want to bring my camera to class because it's still raining and I don't want to risk it getting wet. So I'll probably just film on my phone. It'll be a little awkward to watch, but at least it's something. So yeah, I'll see you guys in a bit.
Alright, we're back at my flat. I'm pretty sure the lady at reception of my building thinks I'm unhinged because this is, Tuesday. So I got an Amazon package Friday and an Amazon package Monday, and I got an Amazon package today. Today I got a whole diffuser for my room. Oh, it's a lot bigger than I expected. Oh my lord. Okay. I got a little essential oil diffuser for my room. I had one that I got, I want to say, it's like they call TJ Maxx, TK Maxx here. I think that is very interesting. But I wanted one, and the one I got at TK Maxx broke the other day, like the base won't come off it, so I can't put any more essential oil in it. So I got this one. I'm very excited about it. It came with like a remote, and I can like change the color of the light on this. Like, this is some high-tech stuff. I'm very excited about this. I'm gonna set that up, and then I don't think I have anything to do for the rest of the day. I'll probably like just watch Criminal Minds and crochet and play at my home. Yeah, it's a pretty chill day. Tomorrow I think I have two seminars tomorrow. An anthropology lecture, and then I have my other anthropology lecture. And one's at noon and the other one is at 4. So that's a pretty good split. I'll probably just come home for those 4 hours because I don't see the point being out for 4 hours, because I'll probably just spend money on like coffee or something, and we're trying to watch our spending. So, all right, fun story. I went to throw everything together and I realized all the stuff of me out in town, you could not hear what I was saying at all. So yeah, I went to my first class today. The lecture hall was actually really nice. They reminded me a lot of home. The professor was super nice. It was an intro level sports psychology course, which is super interesting to me. So I figured I'd give it a shot, because those kind of courses really aren't available to me at home. The only problem is I'm way out of my depth in that course, I feel like. Like, the prof was talking a lot about psychology, which I do have a background in because I take anthropology courses, and a lot of the social sciences like anthropology, sociology, and psychology trade off a lot on theories and ideas and even people that develop theories. But the way the prof was talking about like theories and in psychology and stuff, I realized like I didn't really know what he was talking about, or I was like, about it. So I think he has office hours Thursday mornings, so I'm gonna go and visit him, I feel like, and just be like, hey, like, am I qualified to take this course? But after that, I went to the grocery store, did a good little Tesco run. I got like a decent amount of stuff. I got like some instant soup and instant noodles, because that's easy stuff to make. I found some spaghetti bolognese that you can either do in the microwave or the oven, which intrigued me. I got some celery, some apple slices, and then there was like the pineapple slices, and there's a little container, so they're like perfect snack sizes, and some yogurt. So I was very excited about that. Alright, this is where we'll be right off today. I'm still about to go make dinner and hang out for the rest of the night, so not really anything too interesting. I really appreciate everyone that's watching this. This is actually like one of my longer videos, which I'm pretty excited about. I wish I could have shown like more of my day rather than me just talking to a camera, but I'm hoping in the future I can record a little bit more, and so you guys get to see a little bit more of my life rather than just the room I stay in. So I'll hopefully try and do some of that. So as we know, end of video, we all gotta take a drink of water. And it's the first time I think I've actually had a decent drink of water at the end of my video. Thank you guys so much for watching. Make sure to like, comment, subscribe if you want to see any more of my content, and have a great day. See you, healthy guys.